Hi! In this video, we'll be seeing how to file GSTR-3B returns from Zoho Books. GSTR-3B is a monthly return to be filed before the 20th of the following month. It's a consolidated summary of the outward supplies, inward supplies, and the ITC available. The process of filing GSTR-3B involves the following steps: enabling API access in the GST portal and answering filing-related questions, pushing your data from Zoho Books, payment of tax, and filing your returns in the GST portal. Zoho Books connects with your GSTN account using APIs. Therefore, the first step is to enable the API access in your account to establish this connection. Log into the GST portal and click on My Profile. Then click on Manage API Access and enable the API request. Choose the duration as per your preference and then click Confirm. Then go to the Returns dashboard. Select the financial year and the return filing period and click Search. Click on the Prepare Online option under Monthly Return GSTR-3B and answer the set of questions that gets displayed. Then click Next. Based on your answers to those questions, the relevant tables of the GSTR-3B will be populated. The next step is to push the data from Zoho Books to the GST portal. Log into Zoho Books and go to the GST filing tab. Select the month from the drop-down and click on View Summary against GSTR-3B Summary. Then verify your data. And click on Push to GSTN. An OTP will be sent to your mobile number and email ID registered with GST. Enter that OTP and click on Verify and Push. The consolidated data of your sales and purchases along with the ITC of that month will be pushed to the GST portal. ITC reversal. As per rules 42 and 43 of CGST rules, input tax credit must be reversed in the following cases: when the goods or services have been used partly for business and partly for purposes other than business, when the supplies include taxable, exempt, and nil-rated products, if the supplier of goods or service is not paid within 180 days of the issue of tax invoice, and any other ITC that has been reversed. If there's ITC reversal, please edit and give the details before pushing your data. Once your data is pushed to the GST portal, you'll receive an in-app notification. You can then log into the GST portal, choose the financial year and the reporting period, and click Search. Then click on Prepare Online under GSTR-3B, verify your data, and click Save GSTR-3B. A success message will be displayed on top of the page that the last save request has been processed successfully. You can then click Preview Draft GSTR-3B for the PDF of the summary. Next, you need to pay your taxes. This step can be further split into two sub-steps: determining your tax liability, and then creating the challan and making the payment. In the first step, you can determine the tax that you are liable to pay to the government. Click on Proceed to Payment. Here, as you can see, the available cash balances and the ITC are auto-filled in the offset liability box. You can adjust the ITC and the cash ledger balance, and the amount to be paid in cash will change accordingly. If the ITC and the cash ledger balances is more than or equal to the tax liability, you can directly click on Make Payment or Post Credit to Ledger and offset your liabilities. However, if your liability is greater than the available ITC and the cash balance, you can view the balance amount to be paid in cash here and pay the deficit amount by creating a challan. To create a challan, please click here. The total challan amount will be auto-filled and you cannot make any changes to it. Then select the payment mode, whether e-payment, over-the-counter, or NEFT or RTGS, and then generate the challan. Once the payment is done, a confirmation message is displayed. You can then go back to the table 6.1 Payment of Taxes and click on Make Payment or Post Credit to Ledger to offset your liabilities. Note: once you have clicked on Make Payment or Post Credit to Ledger, you will not be able to make any changes to the GSTR-3B form. You have now reached the final step of filing your GSTR-3B returns. Click on Proceed to File. You can either choose File with DSE, where you will be uploading your digital signature, or File with EVC, where you'll enter the OTP that is sent to your mobile number and email ID registered with GST. You have now successfully filed your GSTR-3B returns. You'll also be able to see that the status has changed to filed. You can click Download File GSTR-3B for the summary. After filing the returns in the GST portal, there are a couple of steps that needs to be followed inside Zoho Books so that your book of accounts is in sync with the ledgers in the GST portal. Mark as filed. Once you have filed your GSTR-3B returns in the GST portal, you need to mark it as filed inside Zoho Books. Log into Zoho Books and go to the GST filing module. Go to the GSTR-3B summary and click on the filing tab. Now click on mark as filed. Enter the date of filing the return and you can also enter the acknowledgement number. Then click confirm. Now generate the OTP. An OTP will be sent to your registered mobile number and email ID. Enter it and click verify OTP. Your GSTR-3B returns has been marked as filed inside Zoho Books. Automatically, a journal entry will be passed to offset the liabilities between the ledgers. To view the journal entry, please click here. If you have created a challan and paid tax through cash, then you need to record an expense for the same inside Zoho Books. Go to the Purchases module and click on Expenses. Click here to create a new expense. Choose the expense type as Services and click on Itemize. Select the respective bank or cash account through which you made the payment as the paid through. And choose the GST treatment as out of scope. Based on your tax payment, select the respective cash ledger account as the expense account and enter the amount that you've paid. Make sure to include all the taxes that you've paid and their corresponding cash ledger accounts. As soon as you mark your return as filed inside Zoho Books, all these expense accounts are generated automatically along with the manual journal. Now click Save to record the expense. This will clear the tax liabilities. If there's reverse charge in the previous month that you wish to be converted as ITC for this month, then you will have to create a manual journal inside Zoho Books. Go to Accountant and click on Manual Journals. Click here to create a new journal. Select the account reverse charge tax input but not due as the credit account and the relevant input tax account such as input IGST, input CGST, input SGST or input CESS as the debit account and then click Save. You have now successfully completed the process of GSTR-3B filing. If you have any queries, you can reach us on this toll-free number or drop an email to support.india@zohobooks.com. Thank you.